So today we'll discuss about one problem on shear center. In the last class we have derived the formula to find out the shear center for an open section, thin open section. From that you found out the eccentricity is h square b square t by 4i. Using this equation we'll be solving the problem. Not only this equation, the whole concept should be known. Okay, so the section given is an I section whose the width of the flange is given as 15, length of the web has been given 200, total 250 for flange, and web height is 240 minus 30, 210 it will come. Okay, so you need to find out the shear center. So for that, first of all you need to find out how the shear force flows. Okay, so what happens, the shear flow will be like this. Okay, there will be a force F1 coming like this and F2 from this end, and this will move together and produces a force F, and again this will flow from the same flange to this direction as F1 and this direction as F2. So here F1 and F2 produces an anti-clockwise moment, and this, sorry, F1 and F1 here, and here similarly F2 and F2 produces a clockwise moment, so it's balanced. But there is a force F that is not balanced. Okay, that creates a moment. So in order to balance that, you need to apply a force F at a point which is E distance from here. Okay, so first of all I am assuming this as the shear center C and applying this force F. Now I need to find out the distance from which, from this point to the point C. Okay, so for that we'll apply the same concepts that we have done in the last derivation. So for equilibrium of the force on web, that is this F should be equal and opposite to force applied on the shear center. So that's why I am applying the same load F here. Okay, the system remains without twisting when load is applied on the shear center. That is what the definition of shear center. Only, that means no twisting, only bending, pure bending. So net effect of moment will be zero. That means F into E, that means net effect of this system depends on three things. What is that? Moment in this direction due to F1, and moment in this direction due to F2, and this force. So F into E, okay, that means clockwise I have taken it as positive, plus F2 into 225, F2 into distance is this one, right, F2 into this distance, okay, F2 into 225, that is also clockwise, so positive, minus F1 into 225, because it is anti-clockwise, is equal to 0. This is just sigma m is equal to 0 for equilibrium condition. So F into E is equal to F1 into 225 minus F2 into 225. F into E is equal to F1 minus F2 into 225, where F1 is the average force on left side of the flange, F2 is the average force on right side of the flange. Okay, now we need to find out F1 and F2, right? So average shear force acting on flange, left flange is F1 is equal to F B square H T by, this is a common formula, where F is the shear force on the web, B is the flange length on left side, T is thickness, and I is moment of inertia about ZZ axis. See, this is ZZ axis. This will be ZZ axis. Okay. Now, for rectangular section, I is equal to BH cube by 12. We could subtract the moment of inertia of large rectangle. See, you have whole section inertia you need to find out. That means consider this as a whole rectangle, and from that you add the whole area of this, I mean the length and breadth, and you subtract it. So large rectangle is 250 total length into this is 240 by 12, and combined rectangle, these two are combined and taken, since they both are rectangles, will do 250 minus 15. This is 15, right? Not fully. 250 minus this 15. This is 15. Okay. Into length is total is 240. Here 15. Here 15 reduced. So 240 minus 30. The whole cube by 12. Okay. 235 into 210 cube by 12. So total moment of inertia is given 10.67. We have found out moment of inertia. Now F1 is F into 200 square into 225 into 15. This is the breadth of this section. Okay, right, 200. And F2 will be 50, because see, F2 is acting on the breadth F2. This is 50. You substitute it. F1 you got from here. F2 same thing, but only B changes, right? Applying 2 and 3 in equation 1. Equation 1 is this. Okay, you'll get F cancels and you'll get the value of E as 66.72. Okay. Now, you have one more problem, which is circular section. So, try to solve this. I have sent the PDF and try to understand that. The same concepts will be applying in that also. Determine shear stress distribution for a circular open section under bending caused by a shear force. Locate the shear center. This is of less importance, but if asked, you need to know how it can be solved or how a shear center can be located on a circular cross section also. Okay, so please go through the PDF and make sure that you have understood the concept for that. Okay. So, next class we will go to our next topic. Okay, thank you.